everybody's a little nervous about the engine update that's supposed to come out today. And so I'm going to walk you through how to back up your single player saves if you're on PC. If you're on console, I'm sorry. But yeah, you can't access your own saves, and so you can't back up your saves this way. But if you hang on till the end of the video, or just skip ahead till the end of the video, I do have some tips for you that might make it a little less painful, maybe a little bit safer to load up the game and load up your mods after the update. I have some suggestions there. Check that out. And yeah, so let's just get into it. Hello, my fine feathered friends. I'm Songbird, and I'm here to save you time with tutorials and reviews and inspire your creativity with my approach to building and problem solving in Ark and other survival games. Welcome to my computer desktop. I know it may look like Ark, but that's because I have an Ark picture as my desktop. And I'm going to show you how to do this here. First of all, we need to open Windows Explorer. If you haven't done that before, you can just go down to the search bar here. And this is Windows 11. Windows 10 should be pretty similar, though, I think. Anyway, we're going to search for Windows Explorer and open it up. And then in here, I like to do this side by side. And so I will go over to the drive that I have the game installed in. For most people, it's just going to be your C drive. I have some extra drives installed, so I'm going to open the one where Ark is installed, and I'm actually going to right click and open it in a new window because I like to just drag and drop. Dragging and dropping just feels simpler and more intuitive for me. So there we go. That's my extra drive where I have the game installed. And then on this side here, I'm going to open the folder where I want to put the backups. And I have a folder here in my documents where I put backup game files. So I'm going to open that up and then open up single player ASA game saves folder that I created. And then I'm going to make a folder in here with the date and any notes I want to remember about this backup. So I'm going to say pre-5.5 engine update, because this is probably going to be the last backup before the update drops. All right. And then open up that empty folder. And then I'm going to go over here into this other side where I have the drive open, and I'm going to navigate to Steam Library. Now, I'm just going to show you here really quick. If it's in your C drive, if you just installed it in the default location, let me open this in a new window as well. Then here's my C drive. Then you can find your Steam folder typically by going down here to Program Files x86. And yep, down here is Steam. Double click that. And I also have some games installed on my C drive, so I also have a Steam folder here. So I'll just show you how that works. And then down here into Steam Apps, and then into Common, and then it'll give you a list of the games. And there will be one there that says Ark Survival Ascended, and you'll click into that one. But for me, I'm going to click Steam Library here, Steam Apps, Common, Ark Survival Ascended. There it is. So I open that up. And then the folder you want is called Shooter Game. And then we go down here to Saved. Now, if you want, you can open this up, and it's got all these different folders for saving various different types of files, like your any paintings you've made in the game, your dinos, your character data is saved separately, stuff like that, your mod data. But the simplest thing to do is to just grab the whole saved folder. And if you're doing this within one drive, you aren't just going to want to drag it, because it might actually move it rather than copying it. So I like to hold down the right click and drag it over to this side. And then that'll open this little options here. So I can say copy here rather than it moving this file, because I want this to stay in the game where it is supposed to be. And there we go. There is the saved folder, and I can just exit out of there. It is now backed up, and that's pretty much all there is to it. And then if I needed to restore from a backup, what I would do is I would open this up once again, find the backup I want, and then I would take this saved folder and you know, say that something bad happened, something got corrupted, whatever, on this save folder. So I wanted to try to roll back to a previous save. I don't want to delete this one, though, just in case. It makes me a little nervous. So the easiest thing to do is to just change the name of this one so the game won't recognize and use it. So I'll just call this one saved, replace, and then I'm going to grab this one and drag it back over here, holding it down the right click once again on my mouse, and I'm going to copy it here, and then I would just start up the game, and it should read from this saved folder. You know, it might actually be better. Let me get back into this. Okay, so actually, instead of calling this, I think it would probably be safest to change something in the front of the name. I don't know if it matters, but we'll change this one to old saved, like that. And then I should be able to start up the game just like normal, except it should be pulling from the data of that older save, whatever save I was restoring it to. Now, for console players, I'm honestly, the fact that you can't do this is one of the things that keeps me from playing on consoles, because I like having access to my own files. It really sucks that you can't pull backups like this. One other word of caution for everybody, PC players and console players, you probably don't want to be among the first people to open up the game after a major update like this and launch the game and get in there. I would wait a couple of hours and just kind of, you know, monitor Discord and see if all hell breaks loose, you know, see if people are talking about major problems, people losing things, stuff like that. I'm a big believer in, I may be a songbird, but I am not the early bird. The early bird may get the worm, but worms are gross. I would rather be the second mouse that gets the cheese. I like that expression more. The second mouse gets the cheese because the first mouse got the mouse trap. Don't be the one that gets the mouse trap. Let other people be the testers first, okay? So I would wait a couple of hours, at least, if not a day or more, to find out how it's going, how people are liking the update. And then if everything's going well, then launch the game. The modders have told me that you may want to reinstall some or all of your mods just to make sure that they've updated to the most recent version. And so the best way to do that, here, let me load up the game and show you. So the best way to do that is you're going to want to, I'm serious here, I know it's a pain in the butt, but you need to make yourself a list of what mods you're using, first of all, because you won't remember. You'll think you'll remember. It might only be six mods or something. You think you'll remember, but you might not. Okay. So either take a screenshot of your mods list, or grab a notepad and write them down, but you need a list of what mods you have. And then you can either go through and uninstall just the bigger ones, the ones that are over a few hundred megabytes, or you can click the uninstall all mods button, which is a good idea. Just a second here. Okay, that's better. Okay. So we would go over here to the mods list. And then you see installed mods right here. This shows you all of your mods that you have installed. I've got 13 pages of them because I like to test out mods. And you can click the uninstall all mods button. That's a good thing to do every now and then, because the way CurseForge updates mods is kind of messy. What they do is they download a new version of the mod without getting rid of the old version. So every time a mod updates, it's basically copying itself and doubling the amount of space that your mods are taking up. It's kind of dumb, but they're doing it to avoid problems with people not being able to get on modded servers after an update. This way you have multiple versions, and so hopefully you should still be able to get on your servers. I understand that. That was a problem in ASE. The thing they had to sacrifice was mod storage space, and I know that on consoles especially, that is at a premium. And so what you're going to want to do is uninstall all your mods and then get out of the game. Restart the game. You probably want to restart your PC or console as well. Then get back into the game, come back into this mods list area, And then you can go over here and you can search from your list, search for each mod by name and reinstall it. And it'll take a while. But if you do it from here within the mods list, my experience is that it's a lot less likely to cause issues. There's a lot less likely to have mod files corrupt or break than if you let a server launcher install it. You know, if you just try to join a modded server and let it just automatically install them all. The problem with that, even though it's really convenient, the problem with that is if anything interrupts the download. So if you get timed out when you're trying to join the server, you get an internet hiccup or something, it'll break the mod file of whatever it was trying to download. And then you'll have to uninstall that mod and try to install it again. And that can get really frustrating. And so it's a lot safer just to come over here, and any mod that's at least over a couple hundred megabytes, I would just install from here. And that way it'll save you space. You'll have the most recent version of the mod, clean install, and a lot less likely to have issues. Just make sure that when you go into your single player game, if you're playing in single player, if you've done this, if you've reinstalled mods, you will need to go once again to mod settings and you will need to activate the mods that you want to use, because I don't think they'll be active by default. So you'll need to come in here, click the one that you want, click activate mod and so forth, go through all of them, make sure they're active before you launch your single player game. Otherwise, you may lose stuff. It can be scary if you don't have backups to roll back to, especially, so be careful about that. But anyway, I hope this was helpful. I hope it can help to set your mind at ease, and let's all be crossing all of our fingers and toes that the update goes off really well today or tomorrow or next week or whenever it comes. But yeah, I'll see you on the Arcs. Have a good one, my friends. If you want to see another video of mine, check this out. I've got some really good tutorials on building and on game mechanics and stuff like that. So yeah, see you around. Have a good one, my friends. Bye-bye for now.